It's the rhythm and the harmony. One without the other is just flat. That's why I can only listen to Randall Radio. I almost hope Miller attacks again. I want to off him and little boys for everything they've done. Every day we take a little piece back of what we lost. Maybe I should go find Uncle Ned.
You're quite good at this. How many corpses have you looted before? Escape. Let us fight them off the beach. Let me show you what true pain feels like. If you're trying to escape, jolly good try. I'm glad to see common sense still exists in places.
You gotta reload sometime, Arthur.
Remember, aim for the head, 5 rounds rapid. Heard a noise.
Look at all the blood.
A very bad noise. One can't help but look at this place and wonder, could it be even more fortified? The only good thing about computers is that you can hack and smash them. No two ways around it. It's fight time. Just make it quick. How's about some ultra violence? Very well then, my friend. Classy. Very classy. die, Snake. We're fighting now.
In the gut.
Remind me to hit you.
I'm gonna die.
Trouble's brewing.
Look who crawled back to us.
I've been hankering for another go at it.
Is that you? Is that you?
Another one bites the dust.
Strike that. Reverse it. You're done. Another successful violent interaction. There's that well-known London weather, always changing.
Well met, young one. I am Fru Bisser O'Brien. How may I assist you? It's the name my parents gave me. O'Brien is the family name. I believe you can guess where that's from. As for Frobisher, it was the name of a character from an old BBM program. My parents were quite fond of him, so they gave me his name. I was already pretty old before I became a ghoul. I've grown quite fond of my added wrinkles. Ah, this, my friend, is a Hasselfrax Panex. A one-of-a-kind camera, perfect for capturing static art. It is part of my latest project to catalog the art of Pipsy, the marvelous yet anonymous graffiti artist. You seem like an enterprising person. Would you be interested in helping me? A graffiti artist who has chosen to remain anonymous. You might have seen their work already. It's eclectic, political, and very hard to miss. All I require is that you take this camera and capture photographs of every Pipsy wall art you can find in London. Bring me 20 photographs, and I'll give you 250 tickets. A fair reward, don't you think? That is the mystery of the century, a question that has plagued the art world for years. I don't think we'll ever know. And in the end, isn't the mystery part of the fun? That Pipsy could be anyone? They are spread all over London. I wish I could tell you exactly where to look, but if I knew, I'd do it myself. Art is history, my friend. If we don't get these photographs, we are depriving future generations of Pipsy's art. Your photographs will become part of a beautiful, hardbound biography on Pipsy's life and work. I'll make sure to send you a copy.
Hi, Mum and Dad. It's me. I hope this holiday finds you well. I just want to send you an update from my current post at Crypt on the Green. Life down here in the Art of the Islington has its ups and downs. I'm stationed amidst the remnants of a once bustling borough. A stark reminder of the past. This church, though damaged, still stands tall. Great place for me to set up my shop. I've made the best of my situation. I've managed to secure a section of the borough off, and it's become my makeshift home. The camaraderie among the traders is incredible. We've become a family, looking out for one another. Every day is a new adventure, whether it's scavenging for supplies, patrolling the city streets, or holding the line against whatever threats lurk in the shadows by Angel Station. We stay vigilant, but amidst the shit, there are moments of beauty. At night, we could see the stars from the top of the church. A sight I never imagined in this urban landscape. It's a reminder that there's still some beauty left in this world. I miss home, of course. The simplicity of life before I came here seems like a distant dream. Well, please don't worry too much, Mum and Dad. I'm in good hands, and I've made some wonderful friends here. I'll keep soldiering on, one day at a time. I love you both, and I promise to stay safe. Until the day we can all be together again, please take care. Sending all my love from my little stand here in Islington.
Just when things were feeling fine. Let's make this quick. Oh God! Cherish simple moments like this. Thank you. this poor thing out of its misery. Let's just get through this as fast as possible. Is rancid, and I don't have a nose anymore. Think about that. I hope I'm wrong, but I believe that we're being watched.
Exchange employee. I just need to get something off my chest, you know? This place. It's been getting to me lately. I mean, it smells. Man, it smells bad. Really bad. There's this guy. We call him P-Man. And trust me, that name isn't a joke. He reeks of urine, like all the time. And one day, right here at the counter, he just pissed himself. It was disgusting. I'm at a point where I want to quit, you know? I mean, we should just be able to ban him. But it's not that simple. We live in this democratic, capitalistic society, and money talks louder than our well-being. Sometimes, I wonder if this place would be better off gone, like burnt down by all the bombs dropping all around us. Then I realize, life just isn't that easy. So yeah, it stinks in here, And it's not just because the smell of pee, man.
They have good socks.
It's the system, the society we live in. Quitting isn't an option. We'll keep pushing forward, because that's what we do.
Just feeling fine.
Is your throat not feeling a little scratchy? Ah, I see. You've got yourself a gas mask. Very innovative. Though, I shouldn't be so surprised. It is you, after all.
I've had in my life. That was the most terrifying. Whatever that thing is, I want to see. Remember, aim for the head, 5 rounds rounded. ponder the mysteries of the universe long enough.
When we last met, I opened the door to give you a sporting chance. Well, Wayfarer, the game is afoot, and I plan to win. So this door stays closed. Seems I won't be answering those questions after all. Be seeing you.
noise. Very bad noise. Injury check. Anyone hurt? No? Just me? Let me show you just what I've learned. To interrupt your regularly scheduled wandering, but keep an eye out. vanish behind if I... Just getting warmed up.
Commencing scan. Door unlocking. Scanning complete.
Initiate the Piccadilly Protocol. I do apologize. You aren't the average adversary. Fate is inescapable, isn't it? I must admit, I didn't quite think that plan through. It seems our fates are somewhat aligned. I'll never be rid of you. And that's just something I'll have to come to terms with. You want answers. I know you do. And you will get them. Let it be known. When we meet at the Palace of Westminster, all will be revealed. Let it be known. When we meet at the Palace of Westminster, all will be revealed. In my stead, head London. Explore her. Get a feel for her. And most importantly, be kind to her. It's yours, if you're willing to pay the price.
Can I help you? My God. I am so glad you asked. Well, settle in, for I shall now tell you the most fascinating story in history. Now, our story begins in the Dark Ages, as most great British stories do. When the Mountbattens were nothing more than a peculiar little clan of blacksmiths, specializing in the fascinatingly specific art of horse mounts. Yes, indeed. Back then, you could dedicate your entire life to a single type of work and never really face any kind of pushback from your loved ones. But I digress. Now, the Mountbattens managed to eke out an admirable life, as admirable as peasants could be in those times, and that is why they were picked to assist in a war of, well, I can't exactly recall the date, but it was one of those important wars, the kind that gets etched into history books. Well, my ancestors, who I believe were descendants of crafty little Frenchmen, they designed the horse mounts for the richest man in their particular side of this little island of ours. Of course, they did a rather poor job, which is why they were forced to go into hiding, followed by a hasty name change to the clan name we have today, the Mountbattens. Not exactly the perfect plan, because the word mount is right there. Oh, but those people spent their days frolicking around in the mud, so we can't exactly blame them for not being so forward-thinking now, can we? Well, skip ahead a few centuries, and the Mountbattens have evolved from lowly craftsmen to beloved artisans. That is to say, they made art out of metal, not that they were artists. God knows my family would not approve of anyone going into the arts. The only difference between a beggar and an artist is that a beggar doesn't make you pay to watch him panhandle. Anyway, it wasn't long before the Mountbattens realized that metalwork would soon become a rather unstable source of employment, and that's when they made the switch into more acceptable lines of work. Farmers, miners, housewives, rail workers, the sort. Skip a few hundred years of simple living and you'll get to the modern age. Ah, yes. Did you know my great-great-grandfather was supposed to die in one of the first great wars? At least, I think it was my great-great-grandfather. I can't recall. Oh, well. They pegged his chance of survival at 5%, said he was meant to rot in the bottom of the trench. But the old bastard made it through. We don't really know how. That's the thing about us Mountbatten men. We have a way for surviving despite the odds being ever against our favor. I suppose that explains me. Our surprising survival meant that we had a head start when it came to reoccupying the workforce. And that is how we get to yours truly. Isn't that just amazing? I know. I'm flabbergasted as well. And it's my personal history. your step in here. Not literally, since you can't see anything. The depths some will fall to in the name of sin. It can drive one to drink. Nothing suspicious to see here. Nothing suspicious at all. Corruption surrounds us. Remind me to acquire a dollop of perfume to ward off this dreadful stench.